Hi, I'm Tom Mullaney, that's me, here today to tell you about manipulating items in the Google Jamboard web app using the select tool. So this is the select tool, and if you notice in my jam, I have one of everything here. I have a lot of web clippings, I have a couple of post-it notes, I have handwriting recognition, I have, this is just drawing, an emoji, a shape, and an auto draw, and this is actually a slide from a Google Slides presentation. So I'll use that to demo. So if I click on it while I'm using the select tool, I have the ability to rotate it, as you can see right there. I have the ability to enlarge and shrink it. I have the ability to move it, and I also have the three dots. And with the three dots, I can duplicate it or I can delete. And this will apply. And let's shrink that down a little bit using this corner right there. This will apply to all of these items, as you can see, the ability to duplicate, delete, turn, move, enlarge, shrink, all of that. Here is an emoji I can do that with. That came in real small. Here's an, you know, a shape, a cloud I can do that with. The only thing I can't do that with is the actual drawing. In the select tool, if I click on it, nothing will happen. Every other item I can manipulate. With the sticky notes that I've added, this is all done in the mobile Jamboard app on my Chromebook. If I tap that, I can change the content, I can change the background, and then I also have that same ability to enlarge, shrink, rotate, and duplicate or delete, but I also get that edit, which I can also do by double clicking. So there are so many things you can do in the web app with the select tool with content that's already in a jam that's been created in the mobile app. If you have any questions about this at all, please comment below or tweet me at Tom E. Mullaney. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching.